Hello friends, welcome to JavaScript video tutorial series. In the previous video tutorial, we understood what is an object in general. We understood that object represents any real world entity. Anything in this real world, we can consider it as an object. And every object is going to have attributes and behaviors. In this video tutorial, I would like to discuss JavaScript objects. We mainly focus on JavaScript objects. We know that to solve any real-world problem with the help of a software, we must represent real-world objects present in that problem as software-world objects. We must convert real-world objects to the software-world objects. And that we do with the help of JavaScript objects in our web world. JavaScript objects help us to represent real-world objects as the web world objects. We know that JavaScript is an object-based or prototype-based language. That is, JavaScript objects are built or created with the help of prototypes. We take help of prototypes to build new objects. What is a prototype then? Prototype is an object which contains common functionalities that a JavaScript object inherits. That is, when a JavaScript object is created, it inherits the common functionalities present inside a prototype object from which it is built. Prototype is also a JavaScript object which contains a common functionalities of an object. We take help of prototypes objects to build new JavaScript objects, friends. I hope you understood what is a prototype now. Next, we understand what is a JavaScript object. What is actually a JavaScript object? We know what is an object in general. Object in general is going to contain the collection of attributes and behaviors. JavaScript objects are also a collection of attributes and behaviors. They also have one extra thing, that is a prototype from which they are built. This is what you see in general, a definition of a JavaScript object. Any JavaScript object is a collection of properties and has a prototype. Let's understand what is a property first. Property is a key value pair. Properties come in key value pair. What is a key? Key is the name of the property and value is the value of the property. Value of the property can be a data like a number, a string, or a boolean value, or it can be any other object or a function. This property can be a data property or a function property. Let's understand first data property. If a property value is a data, if a property's value is a data value like a number, string, or an object, then it is called as a data property. If a property holds a data, then it is called as a data property. Data property represents the attribute of an object. Data property indicates attribute of an object. What is a function property then? If a property's value is a function, then it is called as a function property, or simply we say a method. If a property holds a function instead of a data, then we say it as a method or a function property. It represents behavior of an object. Function property indicates behavior of an object. So, you can see here any JavaScript object is a collection of properties. A property can be an attribute or a behavior. So we can say that JavaScript object is a collection of attributes and behaviors. Plus, it has one extra thing, that is an associated prototype object from which that object is built. We have to remember some of the important notes. JavaScript object is a collection of properties. A property can be a data property or a function property, that is, it can be an attribute or a behavior. Every JavaScript object is associated with the prototype object from which it is built. All JavaScript objects inherit their common functionalities from their prototype. JavaScript objects are dynamic in nature. That is, we can add new properties to an object or delete properties from an object at runtime, at execution time. JavaScript object is an associative array like data structure. Associative arrays are going to have key value pairs. So JavaScript objects are going to have key value pairs, right? I hope you guys have clearly understood what is a JavaScript object. In the first glance, you may not have understood everything clearly. I suggest you people to watch this video again and again, understand everything clearly, try to understand. If you do not understand some of the concepts, don't worry, in the upcoming video tutorials, you are going to understand them more clearly because we are going to create ourselves a new objects and visualize them. We understand the flow of execution and the memory representation, everything. So don't worry. Okay. So for this video tutorial, I think this much is enough, friends. For more benefits and be up to date, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and don't forget to like, comment and share these videos with others so that everyone will get benefited. Keep learning. Keep coding, keep sharing. Thank you guys. Thank you very much. See you in the next tutorial.